Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about Entity Framework Core. Entity Framework is .NET's ORM framework, which lets you map your C# models to database tables, and it makes it easier to query and update your database tables. There are two approaches. The first approach is code-first approach, where you design your C# models and apply migration to create your database. And the other approach is database-first approach, where you have database and you run scaffolding to create models and DB context in your .NET project. And I'm going to show you a demo on database-first approach because most of the projects start, they have database team and they design database and they give the database to work on it. So for this project, I'm going to follow this architecture where I'm going to store my database in SQL Server Express. And then I'm going to create a web API to show results in JSON. The reason why I'm going to create a web API because it takes JSON and returns the JSON as an input and output. And it gives me freedom to create my UI in any of these technologies because these technologies handle JSON or any technology that you desire which handles JSON, you can work with web API. Okay, so after I create web API, I'm going to install Entity Framework in my web API and then run scaffolding to create DB context and model. For my demo, I'm going to use Bookstore as a database, and these books have publishers and they have authors, and then we'll maintain sales of these books in our store. And to get into the system, we have user table and it has user ID and password. If you do not have a database, you can totally find this database in my GitHub link here. I'm gonna put this link in the video description. So if you wanna practice with me, you can totally take this backup and attach in your SQLExpress and follow this demo. So let's go ahead and connect to our database. So I'm gonna go to Server Explorer and add a connection. And here I would like to connect to my SQL Express. So I'm gonna say /SQL SQL Express, and I'm gonna look in my drop down here for selecting the database, and you can see that I have Bookstore's database here. And I'm gonna connect to my bookstore here. So when I open and see the tables, you can see all the tables are listed down here. Then I wanna look up the some of the details in my authors table here. You can see author has first name, last name, phone, address, city, state, and zip. These are the columns, and this is some of the data. This is all of the data in authors table. I would like to show this authors table in JSON format. So let's go ahead and create a web API project. I'm gonna say it's a public project, and I'm gonna put it in public folder so that you guys can have access to it too. And I'm gonna say it's a book stores web API project. All right, and create. And it's gonna ask me what template I wanna create. It has an empty template, and it has web application, MVC format, Angular, React. So I'm gonna select API here because I want to show the results in JSON format. This will create Bookstore's web API. And out of the box, it gives me a weather forecast controller here, which returns weather for the next 5 days. Let's run this and see how it looks like. So when I run it, you can see that it's returning weather forecast for the next 5 days in JSON format. I would like to show my author's data in JSON format here. So the first thing that I'll have to do in order to connect to my database, first thing I'm gonna need Entity Framework Core SQL Server package. And the other package I'm gonna need is Entity Framework Core Tools so that I can scaffold my database and create models in my .NET project here. So let's go ahead and browse these packages Entity Framework. And as I'm using SQL Server, I'm going to install the SQL Server. Let's select proper version here. And I'm going to install Microsoft Entity Framework SQL Server so that I can connect to my database. Another package that I'm going to need is Entity Framework Tool. Entity Framework Tool, which is somewhere here. Entity Framework Core Tool. And again, let's select proper version. I created the web API in ASP.NET Core 3. That's the reason why I'm selecting this version. And let's accept this. All right, so we have both these dependencies. You can see that we have SQL Server and tools. Now let's go ahead and scaffold our database, our authors database, so that it creates models and DB context. I'm gonna copy this piece of command here and paste it here. You can see that it's a pretty simple command. I'm gonna paste this in the video description. What it's doing is it's using the command scaffold DbContext, and then I'm passing the connection string of the database. You can get the connection string of the database from here. You can go to properties and get connection string from here. And then I'm passing the DB provider, how you can connect to the database. And then I'm saying that the output directory is models. So what it did, it created the DB context and models, all the models for my database tables in this models folder here. So I'm just saying the output directory is models. All right, let's look at this DB context. This DB context has created some properties. These properties are same as my database table, so that if I want to update anything or select anything, then I can totally use these DB contexts. And then here on configuring is using the connection string here. All right, so let's go ahead and show the database table author data in JSON format. To do that, I'm gonna copy this weather forecast and create another controller here. And I'm gonna name it as author controller. Author controller. And let's go ahead and change that name here. And I do not need all these, so I'm gonna get rid of that. I'm gonna get rid of all this here. Nice. So so now, instead of showing weather, I would like to show authors here. Authors in my, when I return JSON format here. Let's add the namespace for this. Cool. So to get data from the database, the only thing that you have to do is you have to create an instance of your context, your bookstore DB context, and then you can use the DB sets in it to pull the data from it. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna say using and create a context instance of bookstore for bookstore DB context. And then I'm gonna return context author to list. See, that's the only thing that I have to do to get all authors. That's the only thing that I have to do. So I opened a connection, I created a context, DB context, and I used one of the DB sets from the context to return all the authors from my database. Sweet. Let's run this and see how it looks like. So instead of going to weather forecast, I would like to go to authors, and this will connect to my database and list down all the authors from my database. Awesome. So what if I would like to return only one author? So what if I wanna get author by ID? To do that, I'm gonna comment this piece of code, and these DB sets are like connections, so you can put where condition on it. You can use link to get author who has author ID equal to 1. And let's return list because it's returning enumerable as this property. So we'll just return to list. All right. So when I run this, you can see that it will return only one author here now. All right. What I'm gonna do, I'm going to go in my launch settings here, and instead of making weather forecast as default launch URL, I would like to make it as author. So next time when I run, it will go to author controller instead of going to weather forecast controller. Awesome. So what we did here, we returned all authors and then we return author by ID. What I would like to do now, I would like to add an author in my database. So to add a author in my database, I should create a model of an instance of author first, a new author, because we are adding a new author. And then I'm gonna say author, this author has first name John, and author has last name as Smith. Okay, and to add this instance in my database, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say context author add, and then add this author. And to insert this record in my database, I'm just going to say save changes. So what I'm doing here, I created a model, then I added that model in my DB set, and to persist the changes in the database, I'm going to say save changes. And I would like to see this John Smith in my JSON format. Cool. So what I'm doing here, I created author, added that in the database, and now I'm pulling that author from my database to show it on the screen. Sweet. Let's run this and see how it looks like. So now it's going to author link here now instead of going to weather forecast. And you can see that it created a author ID 28, John Smith, the phone number is unknown and other fields are null. That's because we did not assign these fields when we added the author in my database. Okay, so let's go ahead and update this author. Now that we added this author, I would like to update this author saying that this author has a phone number. So first thing I'll have to do is I will have to get this author saying that I would like to get this author in my model here, model instance, author. And then you can make changes to your author instance, which you got it from the database. And I'm gonna say this author has phone number. The phone number is the 777, the luckiest number ever. And the only thing that I have to do now, I just have to call save changes in order to update my author in my database. Sweet. Let's run this and see if this works. So when I run it, it will pull author from the database because it's the same author. You can see 28 and John Smith. And now you can see it updated the phone number in database, and now it's showing on the screen. Awesome. So now that we added, we updated, let's go ahead and delete this author from your database. Before I delete it, I would like to show this author in my database. So when I go to show data, you can see this John Smith in my database who has phone number 777 and the rest of the fields are null. All right, now let's go ahead and remove this table, this author from my database. So here we updated. Now I would like to remove author, and I would like to remove the same author. The only thing that I'll have to do, I will have to say context author, the DB set, remove author, this which we just pulled from database. So what I'm doing here is I'm removing this author, and to persist the changes, I will just have to call save changes, and that will remove the author from the database. And then I'm again showing, I'm trying to pull the same person and show it in the JSON format. And this should not return anything because we just removed the same author that we're pulling to show it in JSON format. All right, let's run this and see if this works. So now it shouldn't return anything because we just deleted John from our database. Sweet. So this is how you can do the CRUD operations, create, read, update, delete. There are a few things that I do not like when we scaffolded the database. One is it's creating the DB set, and it's not, the name is not plural, because it should be plural because, you know, it's a DB set and it's holding a lot of authors. So it should be named as authors. And another thing is it's storing the connection string in my DB context. That's not saved. So I'm going to save this connection string in somewhere in the configuration manager and pull it from there. I'm going to talk about how you can, in my next video, I'm going to talk about how you can delete rows. If you delete a column or update your database, then how you can update your models in your .NET project. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching this video. See you soon. Bye.